Well, good morning, everyone. To tip our hats to Japanese movies everywhere that have influenced our culture so much, we missed up our words today. But the Brothers McBride, that's me and my brother, but he's not here. Today will be a special treat for you. Mormon fun! What is it? Well, it's lots of things. There's no simple answer. Science. Science! That could be Mormon fun. Mormons like science. Philo Farnsworth, for instance, he was a Mormon. And he used science to invent things, like the television tube. And since we like science on this show, we came up with a segment called The Science of Science. Today, on The Science of Science, we will explore the properties of dense alloys and their plastic and cellulose counterparts. Through a series of experiments, we will disprove the theory that Hummers are stronger than sledgehammers, and that hunting piñatas with baseball bats, it's not fair play, guys. To separate us from other science shows, we're going to use these experiments as a type, symbiology, to prove the existence of global warming. Now take heed, our methods follow the strictest guidelines of scientific methodology, and anyone who disagrees with us adheres to science fiction. Be warned. This is a woman's handbag. Well, actually it's a piñata, dressed up as a woman's handbag. But actually, it's made of cellulose. Paper, if you will. Plant organisms make cellulose at the cellular level, and it's called cellulose. We are going to test the aluminum bat against the cellulose. Note how the winds of change are blowing. That represents global warming. Nathan will explain the rest.
Hello. This is the American dream. Ah, a beautiful family, taking a walk at the beach on a beautiful day. The kids are contemplating their futures. The parents are contemplating having another little one. And, oh, here's where they live. A nice house. A single-family residence with a nice big yard. The little niños can run around and explore and play and learn good stuff, like how to get dirty and not get sick. And, of course, if they want to drive anywhere off their big plantation, they gotta have a big car, an SUV perhaps, especially if they're gonna have another one, especially if they're gonna have another three. And look, little Tommy, he drew this happy picture. He has a very happy home. This is the American dream. For these people, what's your American dream? On second thought, SUVs are bad. They use too much gas. And a single family home? You know, with people breeding the way they do, pretty soon the whole world is just going to be filled with people.
No paper came from trees that were chopped down from the rainforest.
This is bad. Fortunately, we have Al Gore.
Now here's where things get interesting. Ba-ba. This is Al Gore. And the bat represents, well, you know, it's the bat. It's made of aluminum. And this guy, he is the true believer. A countless throng of smelly college students ready to strike when the word is given. Watch what happens when Al Gore, I mean, the aluminum bat, goes up against the cellulose. There's no contest against the American dream. Al Gore wins every time.
How do you feel about that?
But what about Hummers against sledgehammers? To find out, we go to the side yard laboratory. Joshua reporting.
This is our friend Flick. Flick is a great guy. He's a small business owner.
I'm Flick, the inventor ant.
And people like him make up the backbone of America. This is Flick's business. He has his warehouse and his fleet of trucks. He needs his trucks to be working properly so he can get his goods to all the boys and girls across America. Now, Flick, as I said, is a good guy. He goes to church, he has a family, and he gives to all the local charities.
You're my best friend.
But there's one thing that's wrong with our friend Flick. He is not carbon neutral.
Why does he need Hummers for his fleet vehicles anyway? Aren't they a little too, gas-guzzly for his liking? And his business. I bet you those aren't energy-safe windows. That's a problem.
This is Super Al. Super Al doesn't need any friends. Super Al's job is to remind all of us that we're evil and we need to be punished.
Fortunately, many a politician suddenly have a backbone of steel when it comes to environmentalism.
For the honor of penguins and polar bears everywhere, regulation!
Well, I think it's safe to conclude that Hummers stand no chance against sledgehammers, especially when it's wielded by the mighty arm of Super Al and his contingent of crazy you-know-whatses. And please, amateurs, don't try this at home.
What kind of bug are you?
Now our friend Flick is ready to join the upper echelons of responsible world citizens. But wait, we found out his building is operated by burning dangerous fossil fuels.
Ah yes, the only thing better than a small business going down the drain is when it takes its insurance company along with it. Ah, the smell of splintered pine. Again, kids, don't do this at home. This is definitely a job for the government. We now join Joshua for his unbiased view of what just happened.
You know, being carbon neutral isn't just a state of mind, it's a way of life. And it's a way of life that everyone will adhere to. Everyone.
Just trust me.
Well, that's it for today. And remember, if born-again preachers see what you're doing and don't condemn you as a cultist fanatic, it's not Mormon fun. I'm Nathan, signing off.